In today's program, we'll visit VTB League basketball game and tell you how the season is going for Astana. We'll have a talk with the captain of Kazakhstan national hockey team, Brandon Bochensky. You will see an amazing show, football stuntmen, and know about freestyle and its development in the country.
Three.
Before the start of the season, few people believed in them. They had financial problems. But now, Astana Basketball Club is the main supplier of sensations in VTB League. We are heading to one of the latest home games of regular season. Even a few rounds before the end of regular season, Astana entered the playoff. Now it is important to rise as high as possible in the table in order not to let Khimki or CSKA get in the first round. This season Astana has set several club records at once. Firstly, they won the most games per season. Secondly, the team scores like never before. In three games, they scored more than 90 points. Now everyone respects us and is even a little bit afraid of us. This is great. Today the game will show a place that we can count on. If we beat Loco, then it will be easier for us later. We will hold the first playoff games on our ground. Lokomotiv Kuban is a club which participates in European competitions and invariably competes in playoffs of VTB League. The budget of Krasnodar is much higher than in Astana. Nevertheless, there were two equal teams on the court. Speaking about the current success of the club, we should talk about the head coach of the team, the Macedonian specialist Emil Rajkovic. There are clubs like Macedonia and Poland in his background. In both clubs, he was awarded as the best coach of the year. Rajkovic is charismatic, experienced and, importantly, an ambitious coach. Is Rajkovic the key to success this season? 100%. This is Rajkovic, his discipline, his work with each player. I believe that this is 100% of his merit.
We asked the players, what is the reason of successful season? They called your name.
This is not only about one person, this is about the team. I think that the whole structure of our team this year is built good.
When you stay near to field and you want to play again basketball.
Yeah, you know, our guys are giving the max, you know, and they are like six, seven players that are carrying the biggest load. I think that they need sometimes extra motivation. That's what I'm trying to give them, a little bit more energy.
BC Astana has never been spoiled by attention of fans. However, end of season and successful performances in the championship attracted more attention to basketball. Today there are about 300 people in the stands, which is a good number for the club. How do you feel? It's not my first time here. It is cool here. Very dynamic. Not as boring as on football. Is football boring? Yes. What does distinguish the team this season from previous ones? The coach is good and the whole team is good. I'm happy. Our basketball is developing. It has become much more interesting to watch it. You can say that now it is a high-level club. What do you know about basketball? Who's the best player in the world? LeBron James. Always admired his game. The way he led the ball. The final score is 83-93. Lokomotiv was better. There are still chances to move up the standings. The match is lost, but the win was so close. What did you miss in the game? It is hard to say. In my opinion, there was not enough rotation. the opponent has better players. If they have 10 players, we have 6. The defense failed to neutralize Daryl Wright, especially since he scored 7 three-pointers out of 9 attempts.
Тем более он бросал трехочковый и с таким процентом, по-моему, 7 из 9 забил.
Summing up regular season, what are the brightest moments to highlight? Let me name the brightest points of our game. This is a win over Zenit, over the Unix. Unfortunately, we didn't have enough with Unix, but any victory for us, considering that we are a middle-class team, is a bright event. The most popular player of Astana is Anthony Clements. A point guard from the United States received Kazakhstan citizenship recently. He plays for our team and is rightfully considered one of the stellar defenders of the entire league.
Which team you prefer in playoff?
It doesn't matter. I'm ready for anybody.
Were there any negotiations about extending the contract with a coach or with the players? Conversations are underway. It is not simple, in fact. The basketball industry is not small and not big at the same time. When a good coach and players come, a large lineup of good teams will follow. Each player, each coach can demand the best for himself. Therefore, it will not be easy. Club management tries to keep everyone.
Я скажу, что руководство клуба идет на то, чтобы их всех оставить.
And it's our supporters, and we too, we're gonna see you in next season in Astana.
I hope, first of all, that I will see more supporters in the gym than you seeing me in Astana. You know,
yeah.
So first come more to the games and have 3,000-4,000 people because these guys deserve to be seen.
Coming up next, interview with a player of national hockey team and Boris Club, Brandon Bochensky.
Very glad to see you.
Yes.
Could you make a little excursion for us?
Yes, please.
All the fans who follow the Continental Hockey League know Brandon Bochensky. The American player came to Kazakhstan in 2010 and during that time became the leader of Boris and the best KHL Legionnaire scorer. In each season, he has at least 40 points, and now he's the captain of Kazakhstan national team.
There's my spot. It's a little messy right now. I didn't expect you guys to come.
What is your mission here in national team, like captain?
My mission? Well, it's just to help the players to do, you know, to be the hardest working guy and to be the leader. You know, it's the same mission as always as a captain, as a leader.
And first time when you came to Kazakhstan, you can't call name Khalilov. Could you do it right now?
Talgat Jaluov.
No.
Close enough. Jaluov. I can't do it. Too many vowels.
So difficult for you.
When I first came here, I couldn't even. I didn't have the alphabet, so it looked really strange to me because the letters were.
You live here almost 8 years in Kazakhstan.
Yes.
Do you like to live here? Just why?
Oh, I've enjoyed it. It's really a nice city. It's very clean. It's very a lot of good restaurants. Very nice people. I think it's very comfortable for foreigners to be here and made me feel like home.
You know something in Kazakh?
Some Kazakh language?
Language.
Club? Bread, right?
Bread, no. Club in Russian.
Oh, that's Russian. Oh, man. Cut.
Boris, this season we were really happy to see this game and just what happened in regular championship.
Well, it was pretty exciting. The team struggled pretty bad last year and sitting at home it was very difficult for me to watch. My team, you know, not doing so well. We just came in with a goal to build a stronger team all season, and we continued to get better and better as the season went on. New coach, some new players, but the biggest thing was attitude. We just had a you know professional attitude and wanted to win every game, and all players played very hard. It was really fun, really amazing season.
And what's happened with Avangard?
They played well against us. We just couldn't match up. I think they had a little bit more depth than we did, so their you know third and fourth lines were outplaying our third and fourth line, and we just didn't have enough depth and not enough good fortune to beat them.
And it was a little bit nervous. Just what happened with Shumakov, and just you wrote something under that post?
Well, I come up from playing in North America, where you don't pretend to be injured, and to see a player to fake an injury and let the ambulance come and the stretcher take him off the ice, it was unbelievable. I think it's the most cowardly act I've seen in all 20 years of playing hockey. So, you know, if he was playing in North America and he did something like that, his career would probably be over.
Gabir.
Yeah, definitely. It's my, you know, I was helping to coach my son, but I could tell that I wanted to be on the ice and playing. It wasn't the same to be coaching, the kids. So I missed it. That was obviously the biggest reason to come back. I felt like I can still play and still be effective. And during the season, it took 15 to 20 games to get back to my 100%.
And you make a business in this time, and just what type of business?
It's land development and housing development. So purchasing large acreage and dividing it, building houses, single family homes, and that type of thing. So it's a slow process. I'm used to making faster deals, fast decisions on the ice, and now in business you have to make long-term investments and take the time to see the results. So it's been fun.
Who is the most strong player in every time played against you?
Probably Zdeno Chara. So big, so strong. It's very difficult because his the angles that he's pushing you is so much higher than you, so you're always off balance.
And what do you think about your career? Just how many years you can play at this level?
Well, I hope for a couple more years. It's like I said, I took the year off, so it took some time to get back to top level, but I felt like I was playing, pretty close to my top level ever by the end of the season. Oh, there's the funny guy. Okay. He's got some jokes. Tell us a joke.
Sure.
We need a joke. Joker, come on, give us a joke. For TV, yeah, we need a joke. You can do it in Russian, it's okay.
Russian?
Yeah, Russian joke. Give him a joke. Yeah, go ahead. Come on.
No.
Oh, he's a chicken. Here's the gym, and I think coaches knew that there was an interview, so they're pretending to work out today. But I've never seen them here before, so it's strange.
How many years you played in NHL?
Let's see, six seasons. I probably like the Boston Bruins, so we'll see. I played there the longest, but I was moving around to many different teams when I played there in NHL, so.
A new former player of national team, U.S.
Yes, that's right. I played in 2008 for the U.S. team at the World Championships, so I had some experience there. And then 8 years later, I played for the Kazakh national team. So it was a good experience to play for both countries.
In next season, Boris will play in a small field. And just what do you think about it? Is it better?
It depends which type of team we have. I think if we have a fast team that can play good in small spaces, it will be really good.
It will be like an NHL, yes?
Yes, it'll be NHL size. I think a lot of the tournaments are starting to go to NHL size, the Olympics and some others. So it'll be good. Hopefully we can learn to play on that size rink. It takes some time for guys who didn't play like that for 20 years. So it'll be interesting for sure.
What do you think about our young players in Kazakhstan?
Well, the hockey schools have done a great job in the last 10 years of developing players. So under 17 and under 18 teams and the World Junior team, it's playing at a high level now, at the top level. So it's exciting for the future here. Hopefully in the next 3 or 4 years that Kazakhstan will always be world championship top level and top level in all, and maybe beginning to compete for medals. It's my wish.
Sararka won the division and get a cup. Have you seen it? What's your emotions?
Yeah, I watched some of that. I mean, that's, yeah, you can see we have guys that are winners and want to win and know how to win. Some of the top players can be ready. It's we'll see their choice in the future. Now it's a good chance for a couple of those guys to show coaching staff and you know, Baris management that they can play. They play good at this level. They can play at the KHL. So we'll see. Next year, I'm sure some guys will be on Baris.
3-2-1, полетели клюшки Краги. СРРК празднует чемпионство. Празднует победу, празднует завоевание Кубка Владимира Петрова. 3-2.
The brightest moment of the season?
I think it was the victory against, probably two moments, victory against CSKA.
Yeah.
It was 5-2 in Moscow. You know, they're league champions and playoff champions. And then also in the playoffs, game 7 to win at home. It's first time in Baris history that we won game 7. So that whole series, 4 games, we won every game at home. So we had great support from the fans.
What is your dream team? Could you tell me 5 to name, just include you?
My dream team, oh geez. Well, I had a lot of fun, so this isn't going to be very interesting, but I think 30s, late 20s, me, Dustin, and Nigel with Kevin Dahlman and Mike Lundin was the best line I ever played with. So that take us back 5 years, that and that line, I think we can beat just about anybody in the world.
That's good. Who will be goalkeeper of your team?
Well, I'd take Henrik. I would take Henrik, yeah. He's playing some great hockey all season this year and 2 years ago. I don't know too much about last year, but he's such a hard competitor. You know, wants to win so bad, very emotional guy. So you can't pick a better goalkeeper than that, in my opinion.
Your son playing hockey too, and do you have a dream to play with him in one team?
No, that'll be way too long. That's not possible. And my dream for them is to only enjoy the sport. My dream is not for them to play professionally. I hope they can. We'll study in school and take that more seriously and enjoy, you know, artistic side, you know, music and art and that type of stuff. I'm hoping they can live that lifestyle. But if they choose hockey, and it's a tough road, but they obviously love their dad and like to come and see me play. So maybe they will follow in that path. But we'll see.
What about your injuries? Are you healthy right now?
Yes, I had broken my foot during the season, so I missed about 6 weeks from that. Just a slap shot.
It was difficult without you this season.
Yes.
Broken, not only you, just some.
Yeah, we had many injuries at the same time. Yeah, it was difficult. Yes.
What about new partners?
So this year I played with some new guys. Yes, with Curtis Volk and Matt Fratton. We had some great chemistry, and we played really well all season, especially in the playoffs, so that was fun. Not just one line, but 2, 3, 4 lines had some chemistry, and every line could score goals and score big goals, so that was one of the reasons we were so successful this year.
And next season we will need you, really, really. Our supporters still like me.
Well, yeah. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate it. Yeah.
Coming up next, coach Bogdan Suleymanov will open the doors to the world of football freestyle.
Bolmu canımda jartlay oturan 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2
Freestyle football, which has been popular in Europe, gradually conquers the hearts of Kazakhstan citizens. It is something between a sports discipline and circus art. Professional jugglers, freestylers are very popular with young people, hence a large number of people who want to learn. Many people do not understand what freestyle is. They bring a child to the sports club to play football. I have to explain them. There are some children who come to get additional lessons, and most of them are engaged in football schools. This is very useful since we are focusing on technique. In football clubs, they don't pay enough attention to it. In Europe, children are allowed to play with a ball to practice the technique until they are up to 15 years old. Our coaches do not work that way. To start, a freestyler must learn how to stuff a ball perfectly at least 50 times. It seems very simple, but this is only at first glance. There are little secrets. It is better to lower the ball a little, then it will be easier to lift it from the ground. It can be done in 30 different ways.
Drop to koyam. Drop to koyam. Bir, iki, üç, dört. Bir, iki, üç, dört. Bir, iki, üç, dört. Ket, başladık.
Бес алты жақтан қабылдаймын баланы. Бес алты жақтан балаларға бірінші координация дейді ғой, координация.
Five to six-year-old children come to me. Firstly, we improve coordination, then we move on to exercises with the ball. We learn to juggle the ball. All the kids are already performing various tricks. In Kazakhstan, there are about 3 to 4 official freestyle schools. We hold competitions together. Kids need to get used to it since an early age. Stage performance seems like a show. You need to show everything that you can in 30 seconds. Then you pass the baton to the opponent. The fight lasts 3 minutes. Freestyle was born in the late 90s. The children in the courtyards, repeating after Diego Maradona, invented new feints and perfected the old ones. Ronaldinho was the one who became a world freestyle star because of his tricks. Now he is the role model for all freestylers. This game is called Pana. Everyone competes with anyone. You need either to score a goal or to lead the ball between opponents' legs. Pana skills are very useful for football players when they left alone against a defender and a goalkeeper.
Басын алдыға қарады. Хоп. Алдыға қарады. Хоп, ақтарын. Молодец.
Now my son is playing football. I do not want him to repeat my mistakes and immediately began to work out the technique of working with a ball. There are more than 100 of tricks varieties. The World Wide Web has done its job. Football freestyle competitions are held around the world. If you have a dream to learn this art, then all you need is a ball and the internet. Although you can't do anything here without patience and perseverance. Freestyle is a spectacle that deserves your attention. We train 2 times a week. Additionally, we work with gifted kids. We have many of them. 2 students play in the female team of the city. The video of the week concludes our program. Speed, incredible turns in air and falls. In South Africa, the annual festival Dog Fest, which gathers the best free riders of the planet, has ended. These guys squeeze a maximum out of their mountain bikes, and it seems they don't know what fear is.